I'd like to introduce Korean Buddhism. So first of all, Korean Buddhism, what I am trying to say, it's identity, culture, and history. By Korea Dharma Master, Venerable Wonung Bogum. What I'm trying to say, first of all, I'd like to introduce the history of Korean Buddhism in Asian Korean history, first of all. So, the history of Korean Buddhism is officially about 1,628 years. However, according to history book, 삼국유사, 삼국유상. This is our history book, 삼국유상. About 2,000 years ago, Buddhism was introduced directly from India to Gaya. Gaya is nowadays we call Kimae City. The 삼국유사 is a collection of legends, tales, and historical records related to the three Kingdoms of Korea, for example, Goguryeo, Baekje, and Silla. 삼국유사 is a historical book compiled by the great monk Iryon at the end of the Goryeo dynasty in 1281, the seventh year of King Chungnyeol of Korea. The oldest surviving record of the legend of Dangun, you know Dangun? Dangun is the ancestor of Korea. Which records the first people who founded Gojoseon. Gojoseon is the name of first country in Korea. The first country in Korea is described in this book. 삼국유사 was designated as National Treasure number 306. 단군 or 탕군, also known as 단군 왕검, was the legendary founder and sort of god king of Gojoseon. Korea's first kingdom in the area around what is now Rayong province in northeast China and the northern part of the Korean Peninsula. It's said that to be the grandson of heaven and the son of the bear. Bear means animal, animal. And founded the kingdom in 2333 BC. So the earliest record version of the legend of Dangun appears in the 13th century, 삼국유사. Citing the Chinese Wisa is the name of who, the lost Korean historical record, Gogi. Gogi means ancient record. Gogi. Ancient records. However, it has been confirmed that there is no related record in Chinese records. In Korea, there are about 17 religious organizations centered on the Dangun faith. Buddhism doesn't have a strong objection to the existence or belief of Dangun. Koreans regard the day Dangun founded Gojoseon, Korea's first dynasty, as a national holiday and call it National Foundation Day. National Foundation Day is on October 3rd. It is religious holiday that began with Daejeongyo, one of the religion in Korea, folk religion, which worshipped Dangun. National Foundation Day is a day to commemorate Dangun's founding of Gojoseon. But October 3rd is actually not Gojoseon's founding day, Many Korean historians consider Dangun and Tangri to be etymologically identical. You know Tangri. Tangri is the sky. Before introducing Korean Buddhism, the Sangunyusa and Dangun Wangeum are first mentioned to help understand Korean Buddhism. If I introduce Korean Buddhism, I first mention about the Sangunyusa and Dangun, whatever. In order to understand Korean Buddhism, it is impossible not to consider Korean culture and Chinese culture at the same time. The history of Korea is said to be 5,000 years of history. Actually, we have a long history. Korea's official ancient history is the history of the Three Kingdoms. This book is the official history book of Korea, the Samguksagi. Samguksagi is different from Sangunyusa. Samguksagi. So in Korea, regarding to Korean history, you must read Sangunyusa and Samguksagi. So Samguksagi is a book that records the history of the three kingdoms of Goryeo, Baekje, and Silla. The Sangguksagi was compiled by the Goryeo, Injong, and bureaucrat and historian Kimbushik took charge of compiling it. So compiled in 1145. This book is well known in Korea as the oldest surviving chronicle of Korean history. This document has been digitalized National Institute of Korean History and is available online in modern Korean translation and original Chinese. So today is first lecture. I just mentioned Dangun and also the Sangunyusa. Sangunyusa is compiled by the great monk Irian in Korea dynasty. There's also official history book, which is called Samguksagi. So in order to introduce Buddhism, in order to talking about Korean Buddhism, we should know, pre-knowledge. That's why I introduced Sangguksa and Samguksagi and Dangun Wangeum. And you can look at these portals, a couple of portals here. The middle portal is myself. When I was young, I entered the Daehungsa Monastery, which is located in South Korea, in the southern part of Korea. And the other portals, while I was a monk in Jogyo order, so I put my portals here. So I improved my English in London, England, about 5 years. So I'd like to try to introduce Korean Buddhism at my best. I'll do my best. So this is first class, first lecture. So thank you very much for your listening. Thank you. See you again. 감사합니다.